You are about to listen to Giacomo by Italo Svevo, narrated by Gianluca Testa for Teatro Formativo. Giacomo is a farmer with whom the narrator meets during a walk in the village of Friuli and tells him his story. James, every time he finds a job, protests and starts throwing propaganda and debates to convince his workers to demand optimal conditions, always bringing big problems to the employ. Finding no more engagements, he becomes nomadic, searching in vain for a well-organized job, so practically non-existent. Until one day, he is called back to his hometown for a particular job. In my long wanderings on foot through the countryside of Friuli, I am in the habit of accompanying those I meet and provoking confidences. I am called chatty, but while it seems that my word is not such as to impede the word of others, for from each of my outings I bring home important communications that illuminate with vivid light the landscape through which I pass. The little houses in the landscape become more apparent to me, and in the uber-green countryside I glimpse not only the beautiful indifference that every manifestation of a law has, but also the passion and effort of the men whose law is not so obvious. I was coming from Torlano and walking toward Udine when I came upon Giacomo, a peasant about 30 years old, dressed even more miserably than the usual peasants. The jacket was frayed and the shirt underneath also. The leaking skin had something demure about it too, almost as if she had been another dress, so sunburned. To walk better, she wore shoes in her hand, and her bare feet did not seem to avoid the stones. He needed a sulfur for a small pipe of his own, and the conversation was on. I do not know what he took from me, but here is what I heard from him. I prefer to tell the story in my own words, first of all to make it shorter, and then for the very simple reason that I could not do otherwise. His lasted until Udine, and even beyond, because it ended before a glass of wine that I paid for. I do not find the story cost me too much. Giacomo, in his village, was called the Poltrone. Soon, already in his early youth, he was known to all the owners for two qualities, that of not working and that of preventing others from working as well. One can understand how not to work. More difficult is to understand how one man can prevent as many as 40 others from working. True, among 40 it is possible to find allies when one advocates not working, but one can also find opponents, for there are more people who do not believe that they have the disease of work, and who approach it with frothing at the mouth, seeing before them only one goal, that of finishing, finishing everything, finishing well. Heck! Mankind has been working for so many years that some little of such, albeit unnatural, tendency must have entered our blood, but in James's blood there was no trace of it. He knows his flaw well. He had to notice it in his poor, thinned and abused body, and believes that the unwillingness to work is from him a disease. I got another idea of his tendency, and think that he should resemble me, who work so much, but other thing. There is an affinity between him and me, and that is why the trip from Torlano to Udine and beyond was so pleasant for me. In order to prevent others from working, James would exert incredible thought activity. He would begin by criticizing the arrangements made for the work. It involved lowering wine into a cellar. Not only he and the master worked there, how to stop the master himself from working. The first vat had traveled rather slowly, passing from the wagon on the road, through a corridor of the house and down into the cellar. James, all sweaty, reflected. "Do you want to come?" the master asked menacingly. "I was thinking," said James, "that you take the wine first that way and then this way. The corridor goes that way and the staircase leads back under the road. Why not make an opening from the street to the cellar and lower the wine directly to the vat?" The proposal was certainly not too stupid, and the master set about discussing it. First of all, the cellar was not located directly under the road where the wagon was, but through an opening could be accessed only from a side field.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.